you know that the Dreamcast birthday was the other day?
Yeah, it was like, what, 25 years?
Ooh, came out 20? In 1999, man. Yeah, 25 years. Dreamcast had a lot of great games.
I don't think that's 25 years.
Sonic Adventure, Ready to Rumble, Crazy Taxi, Soul Calibur. I mean, those were great. Those were greatness. Why can't we have shit like that now? Welcome to episode 3 of the Alpha and Arnesi podcast.
Moving up in the world.
Moving up in the world. We're on episode 3 now. We still haven't came out with a name yet. Don't know why. I've been asking people to help out, but...
I don't know. I think Alpha and Arnesi uses... It's fitting.
It's simple.
It's simple. Point.
Apparently simplistic is the thing now.
Yeah. Everybody loves their simplicity.
Yeah, I mean, that's why the WWE has simplified logos. But anyhow, as stated earlier, we have the third episode. And we got... Basically, this is going to be one giant episode because...
A lot of shit's happened.
A lot of shit's happened, and which is why now this one's a week from last week.
Yeah.
Because a lot of shit's happened, and shit is happening now. As we are speaking, we have the Tokyo Game Show going on right now.
Yep.
And plus, we just finished with the PlayStation event that happened on Apple Keynote Day.
Yeah.
I also watched the Apple Keynote, too. So
I didn't, because everything that they talked about has already been confirmed by, like, outside sources for the longest time.
Yeah, but some people are all like, man, that's speculation, man. And then they watch the real thing, like, oh, shit.
There's a lot of good sources out there. That's besides the point, though. Let's hop into this, because we're going to... We're going to be here a while.
So, PlayStation event happened on September 7th. Basically, it was a hardware event. There was nothing else that wasn't really known. I mean, there wasn't really else outside of that spectrum other than showing some of the games. Right. And
at least during the press conference.
At least during that press conference. They
had stuff on display there. If you went to, like, IGN or GameSpot, they had stuff on display. Like, you could go take a look at everything and... There was a little bit of news here and there about stuff, so but it was mostly about the hardware.
They revealed the PlayStation 4 Slim and the PS4 Pro. Okay, first of all, the Pro.
Pro.
Okay, it was called Neo. Look, they could have called it PS4K. You know, they could have kept the PS4 Neo name. No, they had to change it to the Pro because, you know, you gotta be, I guess, you know, they want you to be professional and things like that. My theory is this. This is my theory. If you've seen The Matrix, right? Everybody has.
Yeah.
Neo is an anagram of one. There's the Xbox One. So they changed the name to stay away from Microsoft. Because that day, Microsoft was not impressed when they tweeted out.
Oh, I know. They were super sassy.
They were sassy. They're like, oh, Xbox One S, 4K, all this other crap.
Yeah, they were comparing it to their... They're comparing it to their Xbox One S system, the 4K, the PS4 Pro to the Xbox One S.
You know, for $299, you know, things like that. So with that said, you know, of course, the Slim, we already knew that was going to happen because, you know, they've been talking about it forever.
Somebody actually already had one, like, 3 weeks before this event even happened.
Right. And we expect that to happen. So that's coming out. That actually came out. Yesterday.
It came out on the 15th.
September 15th.
Ah.
September 15th, which was, today is the 16th.
So it was yesterday, yeah.
Yeah, so it was yesterday here. So today is the 16th of the time we are recording this. And the PS4 Pro is coming out November 10th, which is some time for that good old holiday season.
Yeah.
Oh, wonder how the pre-orders look. You know what?
Sony actually, I believe they tweeted out or they sent something out and they were actually, I believe the term was pleasantly surprised by the amount of pre-orders for the Pro.
That's less than a million.
I think is what it is they're not expecting it to be a huge thing now, but once people actually get their hands on it and actually can start showing off all the HDR and the 4K capability stuff.
You know, we have, there's a certain company that's gonna push the shit out of this. You know why? Because we know how they operate.
Yep.
You know, they're like, you know, they, someone just comes in and buys like a Nintendo DS game. Like, hey, you want to pre-order a PS4 Pro?
Yeah.
Every single transaction they do is gonna be asking about that shit.
Yeah.
For real. Because they got an email saying to push that shit.
Yeah.
So with a price tag of $399 and 99 cents plus tax.
What's the hardware on that?
The hardware on that is the GPU, is the same GPU as the base PS4.
The
CPU is the same as the base PS4. The GPU is the AMD Radeon.
See, now this is interesting because we're looking at IGN's comparison.
This is the comparison chart
for the Pro and the Slim system. They're saying it has the same CPU. They actually talked about it, and it's supposed to be it's a boosted clock rate on the CPU.
Yeah, they overclock. Yeah. You know,
so while it says it's the same thing, if you look anywhere, it'll probably say the same thing. The clock rate is actually faster on it, which means boot times are going to be a little bit faster.
Yeah, and so the GPU is different on the Pro.
It's almost doubled.
It's almost doubled the Slim. Same amount of system memory. Now, the interesting thing about it is that the Slim does not have an optical port out like the Pro and the OG PS4.
Which means if you guys are using Astros or certain Triton headsets, you're going to be shit out of luck because you're not going to be able to hook them up anymore.
Yep.
But if you have a PlayStation already, a PS4, don't go to the Slim. It's the same fucking system.
Just no optical port.
Exactly. They just got rid of one thing.
Yeah.
If you're going to upgrade, go to the 4K, or the Pro, rather. I don't know why I keep calling it 4K. Go to the Pro. You'll be better off anyway.
Yeah. The Pro, though, has one extra USB port.
Yeah, which I think it's for the new webcam, because they redesigned the webcam, and they have a new headset coming out for it as well.
Sounds sexy.
Yeah. The PS4 Pro also has what I call 4K capabilities, because it doesn't run native raw 4K, because that would take a crap ton of processing power.
It would.
So what they did was Sony did their own in-house thing, so it'll convert it, and it's like a pseudo 4K, not running on a 4K machine.
Hey, you know what else they showed that day? More Call of Duty bullshit.
Yeah, that's actually written down on my notes. More COD bullshit.
That's what they showed, and yeah. I was just like,
"They have nope." What they announced during the press event was day one 4K patches for Infinite Warfare and Black Ops 3. Who the fuck cares?
You know what really looked impressive though? The Horizon Zero Dawn demo.
Yeah,
that they showed. That was fucking beautiful.
They ran that demo with the HDR stuff.
And I know last week we talked about, do graphics matter? In this situation, it does.
Yeah.
You know,
that game is absolutely beautiful looking.
It is a beautiful looking game. I will definitely buy it day one, because who does not? Come on. It's robotic dinosaurs.
Yeah. Did you notice that the thing that the chick was climbing on looked like it was like the Starship Enterprise?
Yeah.
And a giraffe got put together, and that's what it was.
Right. So, you know, a couple days ago, or the other day, the PS4 got a firmware update, actually, that included the HDR feature that's going to be on the 4K and the Slim. So we also got it as well, along with like the coolest feature ever is the folders. I know it's so simplistic to some people, but the folders feature is fucking fantastic, because like I have a lot of digital games.
Same.
You know, and I put them all in one folder as like PS Plus games. And then I have, like, all the other digital ones I bought. I just grouped them into categories. Like, I have my fighting games in one, my Resident Evil games in one, all that other fucking shit. And that is, like, the coolest feature ever. And, yes, it is simplistic, but, man, that shit works wonders for you.
See, I was more impressed with the new quick menu.
Oh, the quick menu is
really nice.
Because
you can do so much more without actually having to leave a game now.
Yeah.
Than you did before. Now, before, if you're in a party, you'd have to go back to the main screen, go to the party, and then look at everything. Now, you can just be like, party, and you can see who's in there, who's talking, all that
shit.
Like,
you can share from there without pushing the share button.
I know what people are thinking. Yeah, Xbox has had that already. This is new to us. So,
we're excited. Well, I had it. You know, we have Xbox Ones, you know. We know that, too. We're like, two.
Which, it's about time that Sony took a page out of Xbox's book in that.
Now what we need is custom backgrounds. Not just like the ones on your profile.
Yeah.
But like actually as your theme, that's what we need. Because you can do a custom background for like your profile page and shit like that. But
yeah.
They gave us
Facebook.
You
can update your cover image.
You can like and comment now instead of just like and things like this. And that's kind of cool.
Mass Effect's coming out next year. That was announced at the event.
Yeah,
which Andromeda looks good.
I don't know
locked
why
at 30 frames though.
I don't know why though. You know, you and I were watching the same thing.
Yeah.
when I saw it, I was like, why does this look like, you know, the PS3 version of the Mass Effect game? I don't know why. You know, because I have an HD 1080p.
I know why. It's because the game's locked at 30 frames. They said it was locked on 30 frames on the standard systems.
Yeah.
And then it's full 60 frames on the Pro. Now, that's either incentive for people to upgrade, or that game is so graphically intensive that the GPU can't fully run it at 60 frames that smoothly, so they locked it.
Yeah.
Which is a good and bad thing, because there's still a lot of games that still lock at 30 frames, and a lot of people don't even realize, because there's a lot of background stuff going on to kind of smooth shit out. But I don't think it's that big a deal. The game looks great either way.
I know we're going to see some more stuff from Mass Effect Andromeda, but what I was looking at...
We also don't know how early footage that was either.
Yeah,
they didn't say if it was alpha footage, beta footage, or what.
Yeah, and things like that. And
it's still got room to improve.
It does. I mean, I've played the 1, 2, and 3. I never beat them, but I've played them.
Same here.
3, I actually did only online shit only.
I did that for a while when I got my Wii U. That was like one of my first games, and I played that online a crap ton. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun online, because you're like with people, and like you have someone on the headset going, remember to cover, okay?
Yeah.
And then things like that. I remember that, but that was a lot of fun, and we would, you know, I was like... I think I did the campaign for Mass Effect 3. I really don't know.
I don't remember if I did or not.
You know, that's the thing. And the fact is that with Mass Effect Andromeda coming out, you know, a lot of people are excited. It's not Shepard, though.
No, it's not Shepard. Which is a good and bad thing.
It's a good and bad thing. But, you know, it's time. I mean, a new character is okay.
Yeah,
and
plus this is supposed to be, if I remember, this is supposed to be, like, set way before the Mass Effect trilogy now. So this is like...
So that means no Keith David.
Right.
Fuck.
All right.
No, we might as well just cancel the whole series now. Ain't no fucking Keith David. All that other shit.
He's out. He's out.
Oh my God. Ain't no Keith David. Okay.
All right.
I'm better now.
So we only have a couple more things to wrap up on the PlayStation event. Netflix and YouTube is going to have their own native PS4 Pro app that's streaming 4K content.
I really don't care.
That's for all you 4K buffs out there.
Like, seriously, as long as it's, like, watchable.
See, the thing with this, the thing that that I like that they're doing now, they're getting in the 4K game. Microsoft is, too. I'm not just talking Sony here. They're getting into the 4K game around the time that 4K TVs are going to become cheaper.
Dude, did you know we can stream in 720 now with that update?
No, I did not.
Yeah, we can stream in 720.
I could already stream in 720, though. I could stream in 1080.
Yeah, I mean, I could do that, too. I stream in 720, though. I mean, I'm talking straight for the PS4, you can stream in 720. But, you know, from, like, when we stream, you know, we already set that shit all nice and beautiful and everything. But anyhow, I stream at 720 because that's what my laptop can handle.
Yeah.
It can't handle any more peas, man. But so with the PS4 Pro, I mean, I myself am not going to get it day one.
No, I'm going to
hold off on it until I need a new PS4, because my PS4 is working just fine.
See, I have multiple reasons for getting a new PS4, mainly because my girlfriend wants to be able to play games with me, certain games, but I also would use it as a Netflix machine. So my whole outlook is...
That's a very expensive Netflix machine.
But I already have it.
I mean, we were talking about that last week, too.
I know. But my whole outlook is I don't need a new PS4 just now. I'm going to wait and see how well this goes over, and then I'm going to snag one of the bundles that have new games that I don't have yet.
I kind of want that Final Fantasy 15 Slim, though.
I know, that one looks great.
It looks sexy. I kind of want to just buy it and just hold it. Probably sell it.
Yeah. I'll
keep the game.
I'll put a thing up right here.
It'll be right here.
They it's amazing. It's a 15 themed PS4 Pro.
It's pretty cool. It's like dark blue. It's got some gold trim on it.
It's amazing looking.
It is. It's pretty sexy.
It's almost as good as the Metal Gear Solid 5 one.
The one that our friend has.
Yeah,
that
is a nice system.
You know, speaking of which, like when I was doing the Street Fighter V tournament, you know, he brought his PS4, And the people who did not know how to operate that PS4, we had to tell them to press circle when they logged in. When they were switching, when they were turning on the PS4 controller.
They could easily just change the button.
Yeah, well, he didn't do that, so.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of people don't know that. I don't know how I know all this random shit, because I've been playing Destiny a lot more, and I've been telling people shit about the party that's been on the PS4 since, like, day one. And people are like, holy shit, I didn't know you could do that. I'm like, nobody know this stuff.
Yeah, the funny thing is that with the Japanese PS4, you know, because the reason why I knew about the Circle and X was because I actually used to have my old PS1 was modded when I took a trip to the Philippines, because like my mom and dad like bought me a shit ton of games for my birthday because they were like super cheap. Like I had 15 PS1 games for $40 US. Jesus. And they were like brand new. Like, just came out, like, maybe, like, almost a month ago.
That's crazy.
Yeah. So, they were super cheap. But they had to pay to get it modded. So, I got a modded PS3, a PS1. And I was like, you know, I kept pressing X because that's what I was used to.
Yeah.
I'm like, why does it keep going back? And then I was like, remembered Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah.
You had to press circle. So, that was kind of funny right there. So, the PS4 Pro will be $399. The PS3 Slim, 3 Slim, 4 Slim will be $299.99, which is the same price as the OG PS4.
Yeah.
Now, it's kind of make me wonder. I mean, it seems like they're going to discontinue the OG PS4.
Well, yeah.
I mean, they're just going to sell out the rest of the stuff, but I wonder if there's going to be a lower price. Like maybe bump it down $50. But I'm probably thinking not, because they want to sell these.
I don't think they'll drop it. They're the same system. They're just missing an optical port.
Yeah.
I can't see them dropping the price on it just for that. If anything, they'll just do like a mass recall from like vendors. Hmm. Like Best Buy, whatever. They have whatever stock of the OG PS4s, Sony will just recall them and repurpose them.
So what did you think of the PlayStation event?
It was good. There was it wasn't an event for everybody. No. There is a lot of technical talk that I have a few friends that I talk to like on a daily basis in a group on Facebook, and they were looking at all the pretty pictures, but they weren't understanding what all that meant, and I had to keep breaking it down for them as to what shit meant.
Yeah.
It was a good event for what it was if you understood what they were talking about. My main issue with all this is if you want to take full advantage of what the Pro can offer, you have to have not only a 4K TV, but an HDR-ready TV.
Yeah, which I don't have.
But you can still use HDR even if you don't have an HDR TV, because even though you don't have an HDR TV, it'll still bump up what's running through the 1080. So you'll still get some sharper picture and stuff like that.
By the way, our friend Leon is thinking that we're watching the Japan Cup right now.
Yeah, he is crazy.
Yeah. I mean, I told him what we were doing.
Yeah.
Shouts to Leon Ponrana. He's our friend who is going to University of Illinois Chicago. And, well, yeah. He's the other Asian in the group.
Yeah.
For those that can't tell, I'm actually half Asian, not Mexican. I know people are still going to think that. But anyhow...
The biggest issue that I have with the PS4 Pro is the price.
Yeah, $400. I mean, that was the same price as the fucking basic, the base of the Xbox One without the Kinect.
Right. My main issue with it, $400, that's not a bad price point.
They need to come out with some shit with it, man. Like a game, a Harambe poster, a fucking camera with it, or something. Because, like, you know, the PS4 that
launched... They have another bundle coming out with it.
Yeah?
They have a bundle coming out. You're not going to like the price, but they have a bundle coming out. This is what I'm getting to. So, the whole point of the Pro is for... It's meant to go hand-in-hand with the VR.
Right.
That being said, the VR itself is $400.
Yeah.
So, you're going to spend about it's going to be about 800 in total for the system and the VR headset. And then not only that, you got to toss Move controllers in there, and you got to toss a...
I thought the VR is coming with the controller.
It might come with the controllers, but it's definitely not coming with the the new camera, which is another $50 there. So we're talking close to $900 after tax and everything.
First of all, I'm not going to jump on the VR bandwagon yet.
No, but that's the bundle that's coming out. But you know everybody is. It's coming out holiday season.
It's the new thing.
Yeah, VR is the new thing.
You know how many times...
It's cool,
but... Okay, so here's the funny thing about VR is that there's been at least one generation that tried to introduce VR and it has failed.
This is different, though, because VR is very prominent in PC gaming right now, and they have it down to a head.
So what would you prefer, the PSVR, the HTC
Vive,
the Samsung one, the Oculus Rift, or the HoloLens?
Out of everything that I've been keeping up with, the Vive is definitely the way to go if you just want a general VR experience, if you have a computer that can run it. The PlayStation VR is going to be like the poor man's VR system.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to tell you right now, VR headsets on PC are about $700 on the low end for just the headset.
Right.
You need to toss in your extra controllers. You need to toss in all the hardware to get your PC VR ready.
But I don't know if I want to look extra goofy, though.
You're going to look the same no matter what you're wearing. HoloLens, though. HoloLens has some tech that I've seen and have been keeping up with that looks very promising.
The HoloLens has a lot of cool ideas. Because, I mean, you got, a pair of glasses, and, it just shows up right in front of you. Maybe it looks like it's more promising than Google Glass.
Yeah. Everything's more promising than Google Glass.
Please, Google, do not flag this video. Just whatever you do.
I don't think they'll flag it.
No, they won't. I think they have been admitted. But my impression of the conference was, I liked it. Like some of the demonstrations. Did not care about COD, though, whatsoever.
That's the thing I didn't... I understand Sony has the licensing to get everything on PS4 first for COD now instead of Microsoft. But who the hell cares if you're getting... That's a day one patch no matter what.
The funny thing is, I bet you if it wasn't named Call of Duty and just named something else, people would go apeshit over that.
Yeah.
And then it turns out it's actually Call of Duty, and it's just like, That's the thing. The guy who was presenting the whole thing, was his name Mark Seri?
I don't remember his name. They had the two guys. They had like the first guy was like...
I got to send you the picture because I was like, doesn't he look like a serial killer? Or something like that. I got to send it to you. But
the first guy had such a soothing voice. Like I could listen to that guy talk for hours and just be chill.
I know.
Then the second guy came out and he was on a whole nother level.
He was on a whole nother level. But the first guy though, was cool.
Yeah, first guy was chill.
So, I mean, I think the PS4 Slim will actually be more successful than in terms of sales wise.
I don't think it will because it's just taking over the OG PS4s. And okay, think about it this way: if you don't have a PS4, and it's only like $100 difference, and it's going to be 4K ready and all that, wouldn't you want to get that over the other one?
Depends on who you are.
I mean, that's true. It depends on who you are, but if you think about it, it's old tech. It's old tech in a new case.
Yeah, that's basically what it is. It's gonna be interesting. I won't get the Pro yet.
No, I'm gonna wait.
I'm gonna wait. And the funny thing is that the Pro looks like two PS4s stacked together.
Yeah. Did you see all the memes coming out of it?
No, but I'm sure you'll.
Somebody made like stairs.
I'm sure you will put some right here.
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 Maybe here.
Here. I don't know. You do your magic. That's because you're a witch or whatever.
Wizard.
A wizard.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Yeah, you're a wizard, Harry. So,
we got to segue into another event that's actually ongoing because, you know, we live in the States and it's actually going on right now because it's daytime over there. It's the Tokyo Game Show. And we must segue into that. Man, can you believe the Tokyo Game Show is going on right now?
I can.
I mean, this is usually when they have it.
Yeah. And I mean, also, my phone has been going off like all hell in the morning.
I know, but it's like some cool stuff. Digimon!
I know Digimon.
Digimon!
I damn near wet myself when I saw that.
I was like, Digimon World, what?
Not only are we getting a second Digimon game on PS4 in the States, but it's Digimon World.
It's Digimon World. You saw the trailer when WarGreymon and Metal Garurumon were just busting shit up.
It was. I'm sad that it was just like a put together CG trailer. I mean, it looked cool, but I want to see some gameplay of it. I want to see what they're working with.
I want to see. I wonder if it's going to be like Cyber Sleuth.
I hope it's not. I hope it's like the OG
ones. I hope it is just like the OG one.
If it's like the OG ones, I'll be so happy.
I know.
I'll be so happy. My life will be complete.
It would. Because that's just some greatness right there, man. I remember playing Digimon World. I only played, I think, the first two. I never played the 3 and 4.
See, I never played the first two. I've watched a friend play 3, then me and him co-opted in 4. Hmm. And it was some of the best times I've ever had.
Yeah.
It's such a great game. I love Digimon, though, so I mean.
So you told me that Metal Gear Survive is being made by the GS5 crew.
Yeah, that I put this in here because I wanted to at least touch on it since we talked about it in our first podcast. After everybody spazzed out, Konami's like, oh, no. It's being made by the Metal Gear Solid 5 team. And not only that, we're going to get some gameplay on Saturday.
So it would be soon then.
Yeah. Depending on we might have to get together tomorrow night or something after it airs.
Which depending on whatever side of the pond you're on. Look, I know we harped on it like a lot, but I'm
still interested to see what they have to offer, even though I know it's not gonna be a Metal Gear Solid game.
No, it's not. It's, you know what? Watch episode 1. We're not going to delve into this even more.
Throwback.
Because it's, I don't know, it's just something I really don't want to associate with. I mean, yes, I will watch the trailer just because I am curious of how it's going to be, but I'm probably going to hate it.
I hope it's like 5 minutes of just that bow. An arrow.
Okay, the bow and arrow was pretty cool.
Just if the whole trailer is that, I'll be happy with it.
Yeah.
But I mean, it probably won't be.
I don't know, man, but I need to lift my spirits up a little bit.
How about a question real quick?
What?
Last Guardian got delayed.
Again.
Again.
Again. For like another few months. Supposed to come out next month.
Which it's supposed to be coming out. Next month for like what the past 2 or 3 years?
It's been supposed to come out for the past like 6 or 7 years, man.
But you know
it was only supposed to come out on PS3.
Yeah, but it wasn't until like a couple years ago that they were finally like, oh no, this holiday season we got you.
And we're at 2016 now.
Yeah.
So now, according to the devs, they're saying this is the last delay.
Of what, this year?
Of the
the last delay of this year?
They say that there's going to be the last delay, and I have a really hard time believing that. The game looks great. Okay, it's supposed to look like what a Team Ico game is supposed to look like. Beautiful, not too much dialogue, and to the point.
Yeah.
But the fact that it's been delayed more times than anything, it's just hilarious at the same time.
You didn't have a quip for that one?
I did not have a quip for that one. I failed. I'm sorry. Follow me on Twitter. But anyways, the fact is that it's been delayed so many times that when you ever hear the words Last Guardian delayed, it's becoming a trend.
It's like, it's not even a surprise to anybody anymore. Because it's like expected. Because it's like, oh, we have a release date. No, you don't. It's going to get delayed again. It's like, oh, we have this release date. No, you don't.
Yeah, it's...
But man, so many games are getting delayed, though. I mean, if it's for like polish, making things better, cool. But when you have a delay as almost as long as Duke Nukem Forever, then people are going to wonder now.
Well, at least there, we actually have some gameplay of it.
We had gameplay for Duke Nukem Forever, too.
Yeah, but Duke Nukem sucks. I'm not...
Okay, the OG Duke Nukem was good.
Okay, the OG Duke Nukem is which good.
There's a remaster of that, the Duke Nukem 3D, the 20th anniversary edition.
Yeah, they have new levels.
Yeah, new levels. 8 new levels and new voice work by the man himself.
Yeah. John St. John. That's amazing that they did that.
I probably would get that because of my love for nostalgia.
No, that it has the online multiplayer in it, too.
Oh, shit. Dude, we got to get that.
Yeah.
And we're going to play that shit day one. Not entirely, but I don't know about that day one.
Yeah, I don't
know. So many games getting delayed, man. Like, Kingdom Hearts 2.8 got delayed a month.
Which, I'm not too torp about that because it's had a placeholder date for so long. Even though it was, like, the official release date.
No, there was an official release date.
I'm still calling it a placeholder date. They just wanted to say it was official just so people would get off their back.
The Fractured Butthole got delayed.
Yeah. Yeah.
But... The fact is that some of the cool stuff that I saw from Tokyo Game Show, there's an expansion for Ultimate Ninja Storm 4. It's the Road to Boruto expansion. Which I don't ever remember Naruto games ever having expansions. I'm not counting Full Burst as one. Sorry, I'm not.
No, because that was a different thing. They've always had... DLC, but it's never been like a full-on like story thing.
No.
Four, they started doing story stuff for it. There's like a Shikamaru expansion, and there's a whole bunch of stuff you could do with it. Mm-hmm. It's not just characters; they actually brought in some story stuff, so it's cool. But it's more or less because this is supposed to be like the last Naruto game, so they're kind of going all out with it, mm-hmm. or at least it's the last like it's supposed to be the last Ninja Storm game. So they'll probably make another Naruto game because they're pretty fucking popular. They're probably just going to call it something else.
You know what I'd love to see? What? A 2D style anime crossover in the style of like Marvel's Capcom.
So Project Cross Zone.
No, but as a fighting game. As a 2D 1v1 fighting game or...
So Mugen.
Yeah. That would be pretty sweet. I need a new fighting game to play.
Download Mugen.
You know what? I gotta find my hard drive because it has all my Mugen crap in it. It has Chuck Norris in it.
Now, I am still surprised that shit is still around and kicking because I was... Me and a bunch of friends
used to play with that. SaltyBet is like the only Twitch channel that actually streams it on the daily.
Yeah. You know, I remember back in high school, me and my friends would just... We would make our own... Well, we would download all of it, but we'd, like, make our own roster and everything, and then we'd just, like, go at it. But it was always crazy shit, like Peter Griffin versus Cyclops and shit.
Oh, yeah. You know, a couple of games that they're talking about, Tokyo Game Show, I'm actually looking forward to when it finally releases in the West, like Yakuza 6, which apparently won't have loading screens, which is good.
Which like, is like the standard for open world games now.
Yeah, because like the previous ones had loading screens. Like even going into a battle, they like you know they announce who you're fighting, and then they just go right in. Even though it's like it's more seamless than what it was in the old games. That's kind of that is actually kind of cool, you know, and things like that. So, I know this isn't gaming related, but Pokemon Generations show came out.
Wait, Ash is going back to school.
Yeah.
And everybody's like, at least from what I've seen, everybody's giving shit about it.
Yeah.
Because you remember the last time he went to school?
Yeah.
I'll post a thing up here, but he was all it was the episode where it was like guess that Pokemon in the classroom, and everyone was like, I got this, it's a Voltorb, and it's like, nope, it's a Jigglypuff from the top.
Neo's got a release date now. Apparently, they also showed. dating sim in VR over there, which that's Japan for you. You know, something like that came out here, that game would just be rated AO and it would not, never be sold.
I don't even think it would be rated. I think it just would not come here. It would just not. Look at fucking Dead or Alive Extreme Volleyball 3.
Yeah, it never came here.
Never came. Although you can get an English version.
I actually just saw like a new DOA, I think it's called like Vacation game that's coming out. I forgot what system it was called, but I didn't really look fully into it. It was on my subscription page. I don't remember what it is. There's a Berserk game coming out.
Yeah, that's old news, but they finally have like actual decent gameplay of it, and it's pretty promising. Also, I just looked up your Dead or Alive Extreme. It's Venus Vacation.
That's the one.
And it's a browser game for PC.
Oh, okay.
Which means no, like, $1,400 season passes.
I can't believe they're really getting away with that.
Yeah, I can't believe that exists. And I can't believe that people have to buy that. They can't just have that there and nobody buys it. There's got to be some hardcore.
Actually, there are. Fans. I think there are people that actually buy it, like seriously, because how much they support the game.
That's fine. I'm not saying that, you know, there's nobody that supports. I'm just saying a season pass that is $100. I mean, you get a shit ton of content, but that is just absurd for a season pass.
Yeah, but here's the biggest thing that
I'd rather than break it down and just do like $50 ones. At least then it's easier to swallow in one go. You're still sending the same amount of money. You're just getting a little less each time.
Ready for the big news that we heard? Like 20 minutes before we recorded this?
Yeah, this was like, I showed up here and it was like already breaking. So
The September update for Street Fighter V, since we do follow that kind of stuff, is coming out September 22nd, next Thursday, which is a lot earlier than before, Capcom. Good job for doing things a week early now. Thank you.
You're not delaying it, just doing like a big thing next month.
So, not only will this include Urien, which people are hyped for, it's going to have all the costumes 3 through 10 that you had to unlock on survival mode and be get pissed off at that. And for all the characters, 3 through 10, the default colors anyways.
There's a downside to that, though.
There's a downside to that. It is 85,000 fight money for the default and the story costumes, the original 16, for $4.99 if you want to pay real money. Or DLC character default color package or the character story colors, the DLC ones, at $40,000 or $1.99. But if you're like some people that bought the $25 season pass, you'll get all that shit for free.
Which I would assume that a good majority of the people who play have the season pass, because it is super worth it for all the effort and headaches that you're going to go through just grinding out to be able to just purchase one character.
And if you bought the premium costumes as well, which are like the $5 a piece, they'll come with the 3 through 10 colors as well.
Yeah.
So that's always a good thing. Now, what's really cool, which what I've been looking forward to, is the daily challenges. Like, they have, they not only have daily challenges, but they have like challenges to do within a week or something like that from the screenshots that we saw. Which is really cool because, like, you can, like, earn some more fight money now. You know, you can actually earn, they range from 100 and 5,000 fight money, which is more than what you get in a ranked match win.
Yeah, which actually now, it looks like they boost that because it says fight in a ranked match to earn 1,000 fight money.
Oh, they earn? Oh, cool. Yeah. Sweet.
Then, let's see, spend a little time in training mode to earn an additional 500 fight money. Each daily target has a time limit, so don't forget to log in and cash in on these rewards. The rewards will range from 100 to 5,000.
Yep. And one of the cool things, especially for me, is that they're actually fixing a bug in the game where there was actually an additional frame of lag to PS4 fight sticks on PS4, and it's actually going to be patched.
Which that now, might explain why, because I remember seeing some shit a while ago where everybody's like, oh yeah, just play it in legacy mode. That's probably why.
Yeah, but there was problems. There was actually problems playing with legacy controllers. But I was like, man, that probably explains everything now. that one's for us, we use fight sticks, so that's actually a good thing, because the Street Fighter 4 on Xbox 360 had like the perfect input lag for frame input. Had a 3 to 4 frame input lag, which was fine. That's a lot better than 8.
Yeah.
But this one, especially with this is actually really cool. So I'm looking forward to Urien coming out, because I can't wait to try him and see how good he's going
to
be.
I can't wait to try him too, although I'm not too big on Urien.
You know, he's actually one of those characters that, like,
he's fun to watch.
In Street Fighter 3, he was actually really hard to, like, play with. But I think with the timing windows being shorter now, in terms of charge moves and things like that, I think he's going to be a little easier and a little more fun to play.
He's, like I said, super fun to
watch. I'm actually kind of glad they did Aegis Reflector as a V trigger instead of a super, because them Aegis Reflector combos look sexy as hell.
Yeah. There was one point in the like official launch trailer for it where he was just basically like playing tennis with the guy.
I know, right?
My favorite thing about that's coming out in this new patch, and this is mostly because I have nobody to play with at home, and I can't play online. You get our versus CPU function. Actually can fight the CPU on varying difficulties.
Instead of putting the training dummy on 8.
I'm not a huge fan of the training dummy. I can't.
I actually really love training mode in Street Fighter V, because it's well...
I think I have to spend a little more time learning the menus and everything before I actually can appreciate it more.
It is actually really fun, like, really messing around, like, and putting yourself in a lot of different situations and seeing what you can do to get out of those situations and things like that, And a lot of stuff, like, people found, like, in training mode, like Nicali standing hard kick can actually crush counter even if your opponent is jumping over you.
Yeah.
In certain situations. Or Geef has a stupid reset that does stupid damage. <That's crazy. coughs> And things like that. And I was just like, what? But, I mean, you know what's a really cool thing that they're finally putting in?
All the environmental KOs?
All the new stage transitions.
Which, there's a GIF on the Capcom Unity page all here.
Yeah, it's where Birdie
gets awesome.
Like, put into like a rocket. It's kind of cool.
It's like a rocket chair thing, and he just spirals off.
It's great.
They have a list of what's being added here. There's Shadaloo Base, Hillside Plaza, Underground Arena, Forgotten Waterfall, Union Station, Kanzuki Estate, City in Chaos, Apprentice Alley, and Lair of the Four Kings.
Basically almost every stage that is approved by Capcom to be playable in tournaments.
Which, from what it looks like here, this is basically all the stock ones that come with the base game. So none of the
training stage and the Kanzuki Beach.
No, the training stage makes sense. I mean,
get a stage transition with that. Just like,
where? With what?
Anything.
He's going to fucking like matrix into the wall.
Okay, you played MKX.
Yeah.
Their training mode is pretty interesting, because you can actually like
have interactive
backgrounds in the background of the training stage.
I haven't actually played the training stage of that, though.
Yeah, it's actually kind of interesting, because like they have like, from time to time, the holograms in the background, they change, and you can do like the different interactable backgrounds and shit like that. It's actually kind of cool. But, so, I mean, we're finally getting all these promises that we were promised many Day moons one. Ago.
Yeah. I mean, especially with these environmental stage KOs, I was expecting this. This should have been like
they should have been that day one.
If not day one, which I can understand, because the game came out earlier than it should have.
Yeah, it came out February. There was a reason why they did that. We talked about that in episode one.
Yeah, I mean, if this would have been in some of the earlier updates, that would have been fine. But this has been a while. It's been a while since we... since this came out. It should have been a very early thing, but I'm just glad it's finally here.
Yeah.
There's a lot of good stuff here. There's a lot of good stuff here.
So, I played the For Honor Alpha for a bit.
Oh, yeah?
Because, I got an alpha code for it. I really don't know, like, if I'm going to like the game.
Because it's like weird. It's kind of like the battle system is kind of interesting. It's not like Assassin's Creed or like Dynasty Warriors or shit like that. So you hold down like L2 to like be in like this guard stance.
Yeah.
And like you push the right analog stick left, right, or up depending on where the opponent is going to swing. That's how, you know, if you do a high guard, a left guard, or a right guard, you know, things like that. Along with, you know, attacking with a heavy attack with the R2 button and attacking with the light attack with the R1 button. So you gotta like not only you can, and then you could do like the dodge step by holding L2 and X and moving the left stick wherever you're dot, you know, yeah. Do a little dodge step or whatever. And it's kind of interesting. It's also it can also be a little sluggish. Like I know it's an alpha and everything, so it's not really final, but like it's really slow. The combat feels really sluggish. You know, I mean, I think what they were going for is I guess maybe this is how they battled back in the day. Or maybe samurais were just slow as hell. Because that's what class I played. I haven't played as the other ones yet. But
I can tell you it's not because samurai didn't move slow. In the practice of kendo, it's waiting for the opening and then rapid strikes.
Yeah. I'm not saying I had a bad time with it. Yeah. I had a decent time with it. I mean, I've only played maybe like an hour and a half of it. And then the multiplayer, what they had 1v1, 2v2, and then 4v4. I did the 2v2 because that was like the only mode that more people were playing on, I guess. And like me and some random person fought these other two. It was a best of five, and we took them down pretty quick. And then they like left, and like all of a sudden you're like with bots. And the bots are cheap as hell. And, like, the only way you can beat them is by cheap tactics, by, like, knocking them off a ledge and shit like that. And they die instantly. And even though the ledge is maybe, like, 10 feet high, they just die. I don't know why. It's only 10 fucking feet.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Like, I know it's an alpha. I know it's not probably not going to be in the final game. I want to say it's okay. It's a subpar game. You know, maybe if it didn't have the Ubisoft name attached to it, people would probably like it more. Maybe, I don't know.
See, I don't get that stigma. I love Ubisoft. Ubisoft does some great work. They have a lot of things that maybe not work out the way they want it to, but they make some decent games.
Yeah, they do. I mean. Maybe I'll probably play some more of the alpha while it's still going for like another 2 days.
See, my problem with it and the problem that I had when I first like seen of it, I was under the impression that the gameplay would be, at least movement-wise, it'd be more like Dark Souls, you know? Open area, you can kind of freely roll around, and then once the combat kicks in, you lock in and you're like doing your whole
sidestep thing. Yeah, you kind of do that. Some of the maps are small. Some of the areas are big. You just run towards like the next zone to capture, and you go in and defeat like some waves of soldiers, and then you go to like a capture point, and you gotta defeat like the required number of enemies, and then from time to time, enemies, once you capture the zone, from time to time, sometimes enemies will actually go into that zone and try to contest it and things like that. You gotta go back, and things like that. So I mean, it's not really Dark Souls-y like,
yeah,
in my opinion, from what I've played, it's. I think the character models are freaking huge, though.
Yeah, they do. Like, they look bulky. They're beefed up. It very well like could be the camera angle, though. Because it's kind of a weird,
if like, you can, mid-shot. If you can change the camera angle to where I have, like, a little farther, I'd probably be fine. But, like, when it's, like, super up close and, like, all your attention is to the character. And it's hard to see what the opponent is doing sometimes.
Yeah. Well, I think it's because it's like the camera is like at a waist shot instead of like a kind of over the head shot like yeah. we're used to like in most games.
Like Assassin's Creed or whatever.
Yeah. The other issue I have with it is there's already a game that does this exact thing, but better.
What?
Chivalry.
Not play that.
It's the same game. It's medieval warfare. It's first person, though. And instead of you having to like block certain sides, you just block and you wait for your opening. Because if you go attack somebody and they have a faster weapon, or if you're not paying attention, they will cut your head off.
I think I've seen someone play it, actually. I think I've seen some streaming.
It is a very, very entertaining game. I believe it's coming to PS4 here soon.
So Tokyo Game Show is still going on.
I wish we had some more info on it, but it hasn't came yet. All we know is some of the delays, some of the games are coming out. The Street Fighter V update, which we already knew was going to happen. We just didn't know when. But, you know, I mean, if we had more, we'd probably tell more. But, you know, we decided to do the one a week after because there was two big events that was happening. So
we actually pushed us back a day, too, because we were originally going to do it yesterday for us. But Tokyo Game Show is going on.
Yeah. And he was like, you know, let's just wait a day. And I'm like, cool, whatever. I could sit and relax and do nothing after work. Yeah. Which I have a day off finally tomorrow, by the way.
No, congrats.
Yeah. Congrats. I'll go back to work on Monday, so that's a good thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know, I want to thank everyone that was here watching us. You can follow us on Twitter at Arneezy619.
At AlphaChaos13.
Also on Twitch as well, same names. We are part of GeekE Inc.com now.
Yeah, we're in the GeekE family. Huge shout outs to Paul for letting us join. I've worked in the previous with him.
Yeah,
and Toonami Faithful and all that.
Yeah, so go to GeekE Inc.com. I will also be posting articles of different topics that were not discussed in the podcast. Things like that, which hopefully I'll work on one tomorrow.
Yeah. And there's also Geeky's of it's just a central culture for like pop culture stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want some music stuff, there's TV and movie reviews. There's also another podcast on there that Paul's a part of, Two Strangers, One Podcast.
Yeah.
We're both on there. Just, we're on the sidebar. There's some posts and stuff. I mean, just keep an eye out. By the way.
Hmm? They got a nice name, by the way.
What, Two Strangers, One Podcast?
Yeah, at least it's not Two Guys, One Podcast.
Yeah.
But
I think they purposely avoided that one.
Probably, yeah. But also, you know, we're part of Dream to Stream streaming community as well. Just like last episode, I'll have all that info at the bottom of the description there. So we'd like to thank you once again for joining us. Y'all have yourselves a great night, day, afternoon,
weekend.
Weekend.
Week. Everything. Good. Have a good life.